Welcome to Community Spotlight. We have an exciting show today. We're going to be talking about Friends of the Henry County Library. And Susan, as I said earlier, I didn't realize that the Henry County Library had friends. But two of their friends, Mr. Jeff Cooper and Mr. Greg Hammond, are going to come on the show today and tell us a little bit about the exciting things that are going on with the Henry County Library system and how we as a community can continue to support them as their friends. So it's going to be good.
Yeah.
I'm a library girl. Yeah. I grew up with libraries. And so I know in today's technology, so many people don't use libraries as they traditionally have, but libraries have been upgraded as well. Mm-hmm. And so they're meeting the technology needs of today's, I'm not sure if they're millennials or what they are these days, what they call these kids these days. But it's going to be fun. It'll be exciting to find out what's going on with the Henry County Library system. So.
Well, and I'm the person, I can't really embrace a Kindle or reading the news online. I have to have it in my hands. I want a book, I want a magazine, the newspaper, you know. I don't really like to be on the computer screen after work, you know, I don't want to do it.
Right. I'm still a book girl too.
Yeah.
I mean, I still read magazines, like you said, in actual paper magazines. And I know some of the students or kids that are watching the show are thinking, what are y'all talking about? Paper magazines, but yeah. And books. I mean, I have a huge library at my house. In fact, one of the rooms in my home, I'm changing to a library. I didn't have an actual library.
Yeah.
It was actually a bedroom. Mm-hmm. But I've decided to change it into a library because I have so many books and I just hate that they're not being displayed and me having access to them as often as I'd like. So
yeah,
I'd love some suggestions on how to make my library work. So, but I'm looking forward to that. So
I love it. And one of my new favorite authors, when I find a really good author, then I'll buy all their books. And so I still have a lot I need to catch up and read, but I have been reading Karen Kingsbury.
Okay.
She's a Christian author, and some of my friends in Sunday school just gave me these books, and they capture me.
Wow.
I mean, I'm telling you, I'm reading a book in about 10 days, and that's just reading maybe 30, 40 minutes before night,
not all day long.
And she's such a good storyteller.
Right.
It's fascinating.
That's funny. It's interesting because I found another author recently, too, Kristen Hanna, who just hit the scene not too long ago, and she's written several different books. And I had a book reading last year for as part of my birthday celebration and introduced some of my friends to her because, again, she's a great storyteller. The details are so explicit, and you're sitting there thinking that you're right there in the midst of the situation. Mm-hmm. And so we love reading.
Yeah.
We absolutely
love
reading.
And as you can tell, we both have our red on today. So this is, as a reminder, this is Go Red for Women Month, Heart Health Month.
Right.
And Dana was talking earlier about, especially with women, they really don't think they have,
heart disease.
They're not going to have heart diseases.
Right.
It's the men who have the heart attacks.
Right.
And that's really not the case.
Right. Part of the challenge, Susan, is the fact that heart disease continues to be one of the number one killers of women. And I read something not too long ago where it's number one killer past all the cancers combined.
Wow. Combined, yeah.
And the challenge is because it is such a deadly killer in women, we aren't necessarily paying attention to it like we should. Mm-hmm. Our symptoms of heart disease are a little bit different than men, and so we hear about all the chest issues, compression and the arms and things whenever men are having heart attacks, but our symptoms are very different when we're having challenges with our heart. And so by wearing red throughout the month of February, we're trying to make women remember that we need to pay close attention to our heart health, just like we do to all other parts of our bodies, because this little ticker here, it matters a lot, and we need to pay close attention to it.
And your diet plays a big part in that.
Huge.
You know, you've got to stay away from the white stuff, I call it, you know, the sugars and the white potatoes and the white bread.
The stuff that we really like, though.
That we grew up on.
Yes, we did.
I know. In my house growing up, we never had wheat bread. You know, so, but you have to pay attention to those little things because it makes a big difference in, again, your health. And as women, we are nurturers, so we have to remember to take care of ourselves.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. We've got a great hospital. Our program last week was Piedmont Henry Hospital, and we've got a great hospital here in Henry County. And not only do they provide care when someone's actually having heart problems, we have a lot of preventative things and educational things going on at Piedmont Henry Medical Center. And so we just need to make sure we take advantage of that information and stay attuned with what's going on with our physical bodies as well as our mental and spiritual bodies as
well. Exactly. So. And speaking of mental bodies, this week is February break for the students. This is their winter break. So you're getting
a mental relaxation
from school this week. And in fact, my daughter, I'm kind of jealous. She does all this fun stuff. She's going with a group from church up to Gatlinburg, Tennessee for a retreat. And, you know, this is her last year. She's a senior in high school. So it's about to wrap up as far as all these little school trip she's going on.
Gatlinburg,
Tennessee. Should be a good time this week.
So we get a transportation, a traffic break as well this week. So
we do.
Take advantage of it, folks.
Yeah.
Well, stay tuned. We've got a great show planned for you guys. We're going to be talking again about Friends of the Henry County Library System. And we look forward to the information that's going to be shared. So we'll be right back.
Summer's just around the corner, and with the help from Above Ground Pros, you can beat the heat and provide some fun in the sun. We offer complete packages starting as low as $1,750. For the cost of a typical family vacation, you can have a vacation in your backyard every summer for the next 20 years. So invite us to your home for a free backyard estimate. For pool sales, installation, services, or liner replacements, call Above Ground Pros today or find packages and product information on the web at AboveGroundPros.com.
Hello, I'm Jerry Poole, owner of Affordable Dock and Door, your Broken Springs experts, located in Henry County since 1994. Our expert technicians are ready to meet all your residential and commercial needs. We give free estimates and are licensed and insured. We install and repair all types of garage doors and openers and have same-day service in most cases. Don't delay. Call us today at 770-957-9400 or visit us at affordabledoorsnow.com.
There's nothing more relaxing than watching a fire in a fireplace or grilling out in your backyard. If you're looking for a clean and efficient way to do that, then All About Gas is the place to stop. A family-owned Christian-based business with over 70 years of combined experience, All About Gas has everything from fireplaces, gas logs, outdoor grills, gas lights, stoves, gas, wood, and pellet, and more. Easy and convenient, our staff will answer any questions you have about gas appliances and help you through sales, installation, and service. They're all about you, and they're all about gas.
Located in McDonough, Dr. Aurelius Archie practices a full scope of general and cosmetic dentistry with expertise ranging from porcelain veneers to dental implants, crowns, and bridges, and can literally redesign your smile.
Dr. Archie helps us feel confident about our smiles.
I chose Arch Dent because of the friendly and caring staff. And Dr. Archie uses the latest dentistry technology in his practice.
Call our office at 770-320-8792.
Tired of the same old burger? Love that fresh grilled taste of a thick, juicy burger? Check out Beach House Grill located off Jodico Road in the Gaston Village Shopping Center. Enjoy the outside patio while your food is cooked fresh, never frozen, on big green eggs. Or sit inside and enjoy the beach atmosphere. Offering a variety of beer, burgers, barbecue, wings, and much more. They are sure to satisfy your appetite. Call ahead for convenient takeout. Beach House Grill.
It's the GM Open House at Bellamy Strickland, where new cars and trucks are being sold at supplier discount. The price you see is the price you pay, and receive up to 0% long-term financing and rebates up to $4,000. And don't miss out on Pontiacs at closeout pricing. So come visit us for this summer event at Bellamy Strickland Chevrolet, Pontiac GMC, and Buick in McDonough.
Trying hard to look like Gary Cooper.
Super Duper.
If you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where fashion sits? Putting on the Ritz. Putting on the Ritz. Putting on the Ritz.
Black Tie is located in Stockbridge across from Sonic. Mention this commercial and receive free shoes for your entire wedding party or receive $30 off your next prom order.
Welcome to the Bridge Grill and Oyster Bar, serving only the freshest Gulf Coast and North Atlantic oysters on the half shell. The Bridge is Henry County's only true oyster bar. The Bridge also serves a large selection of sandwiches, salads, wings, and burgers. Open for lunch daily at 11:30. The bridge is located on Hudson Bridge Road, a quarter mile west of I-75 in the Angel Plaza. Come to the bridge, meet your friends, and enjoy our beautiful covered deck. See you at the bridge.
When it comes to buying flooring for your home, there's only one flooring store to visit, Carpet One Floor and Home. With the largest selection of beautiful, stylish carpets on sale, plus brand name hardwood flooring, laminate, and tile, you'll find everything you need to make your home look its best, all at great low prices. From service to selection, no other flooring store helps you bring out the lasting beauty and value of your home like Carpet One Floor and Home of the Beautiful Guarantee.
Welcome back to Community Spotlight. With us today, we are joined by Greg Hammonds, who is the president of the Friends of the Henry County Libraries. Welcome, Greg.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Glad to have you. We were talking before we came on air. It's been several years.
Yes.
We haven't seen you in a while.
Yeah, too long.
You're staying busy. It's tax season,
very
right?
Very much.
So. You're busy?
Yeah. Believe it or not.
Yeah, well, it's a good thing.
Yeah, it is a good thing.
It's a very good thing.
Yeah. Well, Greg, for our audience members who may not be familiar with Friends of Henry County Libraries, tell us about the organization. Why does it exist?
Well, it exists as what I would call a booster club for the libraries. Mm-hmm. Many people would assume that being a government-supported organization, that there's no need for any extra funding for the libraries, but that's simply not the case. And like all agencies, mm-hmm. they've been affected by budget cuts.
Right.
As a matter of fact, now the libraries are only open 36 hours a week, whereas a couple of years ago it was 54 hours a week.
Wow.
Friday, Saturdays, and Sundays they're not open except for the McDonald Library on Sunday afternoons.
Is that right?
That is correct.
Wow.
Yeah.
I did not know that. On Saturdays you can't go to the library.
No, you cannot. Not in Henry County. Not now until funding's restored.
Mm-hmm.
So. Even before that, the library was not able to buy all the things that they needed to operate successfully,
mm-hmm.
be it computers, books, a summer reading program that we've always supported.
Exactly.
Right.
Many schools and athletic teams have those booster clubs that pay for those additional type things. You know, the county provides the field to play on, but they don't provide the uniforms and the equipment. That's kind of what we try to step in and do.
So this roast is an upcoming fundraiser, I guess.
Yes, it's our largest fundraiser, which we've been doing for 14 years now.
Wow. And you are going to be part of the people that's going to be roasting the person?
Well, no, of course not. I'm just the MC.
Uh-huh.
I've never stooped to making fun of our roasting.
Well, I think the MC probably has a better opportunity to put in little jabs.
The MC has a great opportunity to do that because I remind them, remember, I have the last word.
Oh, there you go.
Wow. So let's talk a little bit about the roast. Exactly how is it going to benefit the Henry County Libraries, the funds that are raised from the roast?
Well, in the past, our major project that we've always funded is a summer reading program, and it serves probably 6,000 to 7,000 kids every summer.
Wow.
Again, a statistic mm-hmm. nobody really mm-hmm. focuses in on. This year, we're focused on a new project that's just now getting underway that I think everybody will find very interesting. We're looking into purchasing what is called a lib dispenser.
Lib dispenser.
That's right.
What is that?
It's essentially a vending machine for books. The Eagles Landing area is not served by a brick and mortar location
mm-hmm.
for a library.
Mm-hmm.
And there's been calls for a library here. Well, the funding's simply not there for that. Mm-hmm. However, there exists this lib dispenser,
mm-hmm.
which is a giant vending machine where you can stick your library card in and a book comes out.
Similar to Redbox.
Very similar to Redbox, except you don't have to pay for it. You have your library card.
That's
that does
great.
It.
Wow.
Now, can you return it to that, or do you need to just return it to one of the facilities?
You can return it to the dispenser.
Oh, wow. I love that idea.
It's a really good idea.
That is a great idea.
Yeah.
Now, these things are not cheap.
I can imagine.
So, we're looking at potential funding partners to help the library system purchase this.
So, in addition to participating in the roast and purchasing tickets to go to the roast, you're actually looking for supporters.
Absolutely.
To make this happen. How would they contact you guys if they were interested in sponsoring this very mm-hmm. Great idea?
Well, if you go to the Henry County Library's website, there's a link to the Friends of the Library. You can also like us on Facebook.
Okay.
And you can become a friend of the library. Mm-hmm. The brochure and all the information's there. Memberships are as low as $5 a year for students, up to $500 a year for corporate sponsors.
Great.
But for a family, you can join for $35 and get a lot of benefits and help the libraries out too.
Now, do you need to be a resident of Henry County in order to be a friend?
No, absolutely not.
Okay, that's good. That's good, because y'all are viewing audience covered several counties.
Oh, for sure, yeah.
So I love this dispenser idea. So you're talking about, are you looking at possibly purchasing one to begin with, as you said, for maybe the Eagles Landing area?
Right.
And then see how it goes, and of course with money, you know, expand.
Exactly.
That's really good.
Yeah. So how, I mean, because I know people are going to want to support this, because mm-hmm. it sounds like such a great idea. Truly, what kind of volumes could a Lib dispenser hold to support a community?
Well, it depends on how big the machine is. They come in different sizes.
Okay, okay.
And the space is limited to a number of inches. So if you had a lot of thin books, you could put thousands in it. But if you have a lot of thick books,
sure.
Which these dispensers probably would hold the most popular books at the time.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and maybe paperbacks, I guess.
Paperbacks probably not, because I think they have a hard time
coming
through. They would fold as they're
exactly.
coming down.
Okay. Exactly.
So, well, when is the roast? We want to get that information
roast
out.
Roast is March the 10th, Eagles Landing Country Club. Okay. Reception starts at 6:30. Mm-hmm. Dinner starts at 7, and the roast starts around 8.
And so people can purchase tickets by either going on the Henry County Library's website?
They can, or go into the Friends of the Henry County Library's Facebook page.
Okay. Very good.
Well, we're going to be talking about the roast in our next segment, because the person who's actually going to be roasted is going to be joining us, Mr. Jeff Cooper. Thanks so much, Greg, for coming back on the show. It's been a while since we've seen
you.
We love you and love having you and love learning about Friends of the Library. Folks, we're going to be right back so that we can share with the roastee about how that experience is going to be soon. So please stay tuned.
Pegasus Residential is proud to offer two premium communities here in Henry County, Carrington Green and Villas at South Point. If you are accustomed to luxury, shopping convenience, sophistication, and carefree living, our properties offer that, as well as quiet relaxation, luxurious and elegant interiors, and a safe home environment. Whatever your interest, you'll have the time to pursue them while enjoying all the benefits of maintenance-free living. Give us a call today or visit us online.
Clearwater Pools and Supply can help you save up to 90% on your pool energy bill thanks to energy solutions from Hayward Pool Products. The savings gives you less time at work and more time to relax and enjoy the sunshine with the easy-to-operate and environmental-friendly Hayward Energy Efficient product line. Clearwater Pools can install Hayward's energy efficient products on your new pool or replacement pool products on your existing pool. So call Clearwater Pools for your easy-to-operate Hayward products. We're totally Hayward.
Having trouble getting approved for a car loan? Here at Credit Nation, we understand the credit problems that good people can run into and realize that bad things happen to good people. At Credit Nation, we have created financing options that will help people who have run into these problems get back on the road to good credit. At Credit Nation, we are the bank, and we make it our mission to help you get the financing and the car you need.
I bought my car at Credit Nation Auto Sales, and you can too!
Call or visit a store near you and see just how easy it can be. Credit Nation Auto Sales.
Ow!
At D&D Custom Collision, your satisfaction is our number one priority. We'll get you back on the road in no time. You never know what life will throw at you, but when it does, there's always D&D Custom Collision.
Yep, it seems quiet now, but that could change in a minute. Keeping the streets safe for those who abide by the rules.
We got a call of a 401 on Eagles Landing and Corporate Center. Be advised of a possible 2001.
10-4 DDT, I'm westbound intercepting. DDT, we have a runner. Send backup.
Hey, hold it right there.
Bad hair, bad hair. What you gonna be? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad hair, bad hair.
You have the right to remain with good hair. You have the right not to have split ends. Anything you do or say about the coloring of your hair can be used against you in the salon.
Yep, she'll have her day at Damon's design team. Hopefully we'll never see her out in public looking like that again. Well, that's why we're here. That's why we're here.
At Delta Plumbing, we know when it comes to your water heater, you want fast, dependable service. That's why we use high-quality Rheem water heaters, a name you can trust. Our dispatchers send out trained professionals to assess your water heater needs and repair or replace your unit. And after we're done, we'll take your old one when we go. Delta Plumbing is licensed and bonded, and we can get to most jobs that same day. Delta Plumbing, the skills you need, the experience you can trust.
If you're looking for someone to move you locally and out of state, Diamond Moving and Storage is the one to count on. Diamond Moving and Storage, they're very careful with your all of your furniture. They disassemble as well as assemble all of your furniture. They're very trustworthy and honest company. I wouldn't trust anyone else with all my moving needs with Diamond Moving and Storage.
Welcome back to Community Spotlight. We are so excited to have join us right now, Mr. Jeff Cooper. And for those of you who don't know Jeff, we're going to let him share a little bit about what he does here in the community. But Jeff is one of our favorite people in the community. And I wanted to call you a thespian.
Thespian, right.
You know, I've got the good Henry County Public School education.
That's right.
Jeff is one of our favorite thespians here in the community and very active in our arts community. So thanks for joining us today.
Well, thank you both for having me here. I'm excited. Yeah. I am the Chief Operating Officer at Piedmont Henry Hospital. But a lot of people know me from just my involvement with the Henry Players. I have been involved with the Henry Players for, I guess, almost 15 years now.
Wow.
Ever since I came to the community. And, of course, it's a great organization. And, of course, I've been involved with some of the playing here at SCBTV. Now I'm doing a little bit of triple trivia. So, obviously, I have a passion and a love for the performing arts and support those in any way I can. But Piedmont Henry helps pay my bills. And then my extracurricular activity is being a thespian.
Yeah. That's
and performing.
Where you can sing and dance.
Right.
Show that other side of you.
That's right, yeah. I have a feeling that's going to come back to haunt me as it relates to this library thing. But,
exactly. Let's talk about that.
Okay.
So you're going to be the roastee.
I am. That's what I hear.
So were you just roped into it, or did you actually agree to do that?
Well, I believe it or not, I actually did agree. I got a call, I guess it was about a year ago at this time, from Greg Hammonds. And when I had a call from Greg Hammonds, I said something's up because Greg doesn't call me all the time. And when he first asked me, it was like, your gut instinct is, why would I want to put myself through that?
Yes.
But then as I thought about it, I felt like it was an honor. You know, they try to pick somebody that folks know in the community, but I think I was also picked because I'm a fairly easy target.
Are you saying there's a lot of material out there?
I think so. I hope, but I think, I've always been one, I love to laugh, and I like to laugh at myself. And so if you can't laugh at yourself, what's life about?
You like to laugh at yourself, so you know that people are going to be laughing at you.
I know they're going to be laughing at me. I will be too. So
okay, all right. So they're going to be telling great stories, like you remember the time when.
That's exactly
right.
And
I've known Jeff a long time, so I won't share any stories, but I can imagine that one of our station our cameraman is going to be telling some great stories as
That's
well.
Right. Well, the good thing is you do get to pick your roasters. And you have five roasters. And so what I wanted to do was pick a variety of people that kind of represent different aspects of my life.
Okay.
And so I picked Mary Beth Ledford, who's the Director of Human Resources at the hospital. And she and I have been worked together for probably about 18 years.
Wow.
And so I know she has a lot of dirt on me, and she knows where to go to get it within the hospital. And then James Winowski, one of my best friends and who I've done a lot of shows with, is going to be one of my roasters. I was hoping he could provide more of a video element, or, you know, kind of making a multimedia presentation.
Rather than getting up there and talking.
Right, okay. Exactly.
Okay.
We know he likes to talk, but yeah.
We do know that, yeah.
And then I have Kerry Arnold. I'm very active in the Rotary Club.
I know.
And Kerry and I work very closely in Rotary, so he's going to be one of my roasters.
And he's so funny.
He does. He has a very quick wit.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, he's going to be one of
our
roasters.
Will people understand what he's talking about? Because he's really
I'm
quick.
Not sure.
He's
I'm not
really
sure.
Quick.
So. And then finally, I've got, I wanted my daughters to do it. Last year, Sheriff McBrayer was the roastee, and he had both of his daughters roast him together, and I thought that was really cool.
Aww.
But they actually coach in a volleyball tournament, and they're going to be, they're both supposed to be out of town, so they're going to tag team. So Christine, my youngest daughter, is going to be my roaster. Mm-hmm. And then the fifth one is a friend from high school.
Oh, really?
That's known me ever since I was a little boy and knows my family really well. So he's already talked to them about stuff that he can, you know, share.
Where did you grow up?
In East Point, right here in southwest Atlanta. Right?
Oh, wow.
So not far from home.
Right.
And a friend from high school.
Yeah, it's actually very small. He was a friend from high school. We kept in touch over through college, and then he actually worked at the hospital years ago for a long time. So we've crossed paths many different ways.
Small world.
Have you told them that there are some subjects they can't touch?
No, I'm trying to just like let it be about them. What I've reminded each of them is that I do get the last word.
Okay.
I've been to several events, and some of the roasties have done a good job, you know, kind of stabbing back at their the people that roasted them. But so I do get the last word, so I'm trying to remind them of that. And I've got to start thinking of things just in case that I can share.
Well, and as Greg mentioned on the previous segment, that being the MC, he's going to be able to share some things, too.
Right, and I've seen Greg at work, but I have to say, Sheriff McBrayer, as squeaky clean as he is, he did a great job getting Greg
he
back.
Really?
So he did. I thought he was very funny, so he did a good job.
Okay. Now, will they film this? So if people can't attend, they can
they
watch
do.
It later?
I understand they produce a DVD of it. It's very it's very well done. They have a company that is there videotaping. They have screens in the room. So if your seat's not just the best seat in the house, you can see everything very clearly. And they actually produce a DVD, so I'm sure you can get a copy of that.
That's great, because, again, that'll raise money
for
this new lib system.
Right.
You're
going
to have to work out a deal where they run it on SCB TV.
That's great.
You know?
Yeah.
Well,
there you go.
Let me go through it first, and then we'll decide.
I didn't know help with that.
I'm not sure.
So are you excited about it, Jim?
I am. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Looking forward to it. I've been to some over the years that are very, very funny, and it's always, you know, good-natured fun, and it's for a great cause, so I certainly didn't mind being the butt of the jokes. Yeah.
So remind our audience again, it's for Friends of the Library.
For Friends of the Henry County Libraries, it's on March the 10th at Eagles Landing Country Club with a start time about 6:30.
Right, and we can get tickets either on Facebook or through the library's website.
Right,
exactly.
Okay, good. I'm going to have to be there. I can't wait.
Please do. It'll be fun. Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably anything you ever wanted to know about Jeff Cooper is going to come out there. All the dirt.
Jeff
you know?
Cooper, the man. Well, folks, thank you so much for being with us today. This has been a really, really fun show, and I can imagine that the roast for the Henry County Libraries is going to be a very fun evening. So we hope that you'll find out more information about that and plan on attending, because as much as we love Jeff Cooper, we're going to really love learning more and more about Jeff Cooper, the man. We appreciate you being with us today. We hope that you'll come back and be with us again soon.